Let's talk about a specific kind of muscle in the abdomen, the oblique muscles. Can you show us where those are in the body and what happens to them when you're a professional baseball player?
Certainly. So, you know, you look here, this is our biodigital model, which is it's a nice model, and I tried to cut it down so that you can see I hate to use a Shrek reference, but you know, the abdomen's kind of like it's like an onion. There are lots of different layers. So this is your oblique layer kind of here on the outside. This is what's called the external oblique. Mm-hmm. Let's see if I can get this to change. But you know, what you can do is you can take that out, and now you've got an internal oblique.
Okay.
So your body has different layers on the inside, and the fibers go in opposite directions. So one's going this one, one's going this way, and that allows the body to kind of allows you to go different directions depending on, because you're not always doing this all the time. So
what happens to that muscle though when you pull or you strain it?
So it's the same thing as any muscle strain, whether it's in your leg or your abdomen or in your back or in your neck, wherever. It's all functionally the same thing. So what you're doing is you're basically taking the muscle fibers and you're pulling them apart. You're ripping them. And when you get that kind of damage, that's your muscle strain. It's most commonly at what's called the myotendinous junction. It's just a fancy term for where the muscle ends and where the tendon begins.